Hello and welcome to HackerRank interview preparation kit. And this is second challenge from the warm up challenges, and it's named counting valleys. And this particular problem has been refined. Earlier used to be not properly set, and there were confusion like between two U's and two D's. However, it is refined now and we can easily solve this. So let's go ahead with the problem definition first, and then we'll check approach, and for the after that the optimized approach, and we'll try to solve this in O of n time. So let's go with the problem. So it says Gary is a avid hacker, and he goes on hiking. So he encounters mountains and valleys as well. So whenever you see U in the like in the array, like here, so it says that he is going upward. It can be in the valley or in the mountain. And whenever we get D, that means he is entering the downward or going down. So that could be also by from the mountain or from the valley. So how will we know that if he is stepping down from the mountain or the valley? So we'll check previous value. Let's say this is water level or surface level. So if he is coming from top half of the graph, so that would be like coming down from the mountain, and if he is in the like from the bottom half of the graph or the line, so that would be the valley. So in this particular case, a problem definition says a valley is something that you go down and then again meet with the surface. So whenever you encounter surface from the down, so that is the valley. So we need to count how many valleys he goes into. So there might be multiple downward terms. Let's say you go three times in the downward direction and then come two times up and again go two times down and then you come like three times up. So there will be only one valley. So we need to count how many number of valleys the Gary descended and then come to the surface level again. So this is fairly easy problem, and I'll share the approach. So let's begin with the approach. Okay, this is the first problem or first given array. So let's draw it picturally first, so we get the gist of the problem. So in the start, he goes downward. For 1D, we'll denote one downward direction. So after that, he goes another one. So let's say he goes into the deep down. Okay, after that he goes up and up. So at this particular point, he came from the downward direction and then meets surface level. So this is a one alley valley, sorry. So we'll count this as a one valley. After that, he goes on for two upward direction. So this and this, and after that there are again two downward direction. So number of valleys he encounter is only one. Why? Because he only meet the surface level whenever he coming from the downward direction. So one assumption we can make is that whenever we are meeting the surface level and condition, and the last element or the present element from where we meet the surface level is coming from the downward direction. Okay, so this must be up. Whenever there is last condition is up and you come at the surface level, then only it is counted as valley. So let's take another example. Okay, let's start with the second example. So this is the given character array, and first character is up, so we'll go in upward direction. After that there is down. Here we see that this particular G meets the surface level, however it is not coming from the downward, and it is actually a D, not U. So we won't count this particular element as a valley. Okay, after that we'll go down two times. Okay, down and again down, one up and one again down. So one up, then again one down, then two ups. So here and here. So at this particular point, we come at the surface level, and the last character from which we come at the surface level is U. So hence this is again a one valley. So this is fine if you think pictorially, and you can totally understand how many valleys if you think in the terms of pictures. However, you might be thinking how we can compute this in particular code. So what we can basically do is we can assign values to up. Let's say whenever u comes, we'll assign value plus 1, and whenever we encounter d, we'll assign value minus 1. Okay, and what would be the surface level? It would be 0, because at the surface level both sum would be 0. Okay, so let's try with these two examples and then we'll go to the coding. Okay, and let's check in this case. So first we are going down, so this would be minus 1, again the second would be minus 1, and think this is in particular terms of array. So let's say this is minus 1, minus 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, minus 1, and minus 1. Okay, so this would be 1, again 1, and 1, 1, minus 1. So what we'll do, we'll find the sum of the array from 0 to all the way to the end. So what we'll do, we'll sum the adjacent values. So for this, for sum array, this will be minus 1, this 2 will be counted, so this would become minus 2, again minus 2 plus 1, so this would become minus 1, again minus 1 and minus 1 and minus 1. So this is 0, then 1, then 2, again minus 1, so it becomes 1, and last value is 0. So we encounters value 0 2 times in this particular case. So as we can see here and here. However, the value is something which comes from the down, and the last character needs to be u. So in this case, we'll traverse array and we'll check whenever there the last value, or for which value we get 0 in the sum, and we'll check the same index in the arrayth element. So let's consider this is array first one, and the second is the sum array, and we'll check all the values whenever we encounter 0 in the sum array. We'll check what was the value in the array like for that particular index in array. So whenever we'll encounter 1, we'll count our value by plus 1. Okay, and let's check for this. So this would be, let me write that. Okay, this is the given array. We converted u to plus 1 and d to minus 1. So we'll find the sum array, and sum array would be sum of all the past occurred elements. So this would be 1, and the last two elements would be minus 1 and 0. For these two values, we have sum array here. Okay, in this case also we get two zeros, and that particular whenever we encounter 0 in our sum array, we'll check values in our array, like the given array, and in for this 0, this would be 1, and whenever we encounter a positive value in the array, that would be the case of valleys. So in this case, minus won't be counted and only plus will be counted. So this condition is not valid, however this one is. So in this case, we will increment by plus 1. So let's write the code, and I think this will solution will do. So for writing solution, we will first check the constant, and constant is in the terms of 10 to the power 6. So we need to create that much bigger array, or you can directly allocate that by dynamically. However, for this simple problem, we won't be doing that. So let me clear the, okay, so let's start with int main. Return 0 is fine. Okay, in this case, first we'll check how input is taken, and input format, first line contains integer n, that is the size of array, given array, and second line contains a string or characters. Okay, so what we can do is we can create a character array to scan every particular element, or you can either go with the string and then parse every character. So I'll go with the character array. Let's take char and name it array, and it was 10 to the power 6, so this will do. And after this we'll take initialize the n, and I think it was a 10 to the power 6, so I'll go with the long. So we'll take input for n. After that, we'll write for loop for taking input into the array. In this, we'll take input. So this will be element at ith index. Now we can, what we can do is, rather than taking a character array into input, what we can do is, we can simply convert this into the int array. And whenever we are taking character input, so let's take a char input as a value. So we'll take input as char, and we'll check if given char is equal to u, sorry, single quote. If it's u, we want to assign plus 1 to the array. So we can basically do is assign 1. Okay. Else, so there are only two possibilities, that d or u. However, you can write else if to the do, but I won't be doing that. So if we get an error, we'll cross check it. Okay. So this would be minus 1. Okay, this is done. After that, we'll be taking some array. So this would be again in the same league or in the size. So let me, okay, so first this is like not necessary, but I will initialize both to the 0. So if there are test cases, I think we don't have test cases here. However, whenever there are test cases, we want them to be initialized 0, because there might be a junk of previous test cases in the same array. So this is a nice practice to have. So let's move here. Okay, our array insertion is done. After this, we'll be adding another for loop for getting the sum. We can also add the same sum array into the input array, but I don't want to complicate things, and we'll write a clean code. So let's go with that. It would be less than that of n I plus plus. And what I'll be doing is, I'll increment values from 1. So first value would be the sum of itself, so that isn't the issue. So sum of value at I would be sum at I minus 1 plus array I. So this will calculate all the values for that particular sum, and we can again initialize that sum of 0 is the same value which present at array is equal to 0. Okay. After this, we can again take another for loop. We can do all the operation. We can solve all the whole problem in one for loop. However, I'm going for modularity, and this is like simple for writing three for loops and explain what is going on in what is going in the code. However, you can write whole code in one for loop as well. So let's go ahead with the sum array, and in this we'll again go from I is equal to 0 to I is less than that of n I plus plus. So now we would be checking the sum array where zero value occurs. So we'll write if condition. So if whenever we get sum of I is equal to 0 and value at arith index for that particular I is positive. If this is the case, I want to increment my count. So this would be a number of counts of values. So I haven't initialized count array. So let me go ahead and do that. Int count 0. Okay. I think we have done problem. Let's check if it's work or not. Compilation INR is not declared. Char, oh, okay. It was not char, it was input, right? On again. So this is this is input, and this is input again. My bad. And I think somewhere I can. Let's check again. Okay, this passes basic test cases. Let's check it passes all the test cases. I should add a banner a few minutes later here. Okay, nice. It passes all the test cases, and this is fairly easy. And as I said, you can do all this three for loop operation into one for loop as well. So the you can implement that. And after this, I think two problems are left in the warm up challenges. And after this, we would be moving to the dictionary and hash maps. So if you are someone who is completing or solving all the HackerRank interview playlist kit, like solving whole series, do check for the further videos. Thank you. Have a great rest of the day.